Whenever we do VLOOKUP in Excel based on some numeric fields, in that scenario, we should be very careful whether all our source data is correctly formatted or not. Because there is a chance that some numbers are stored as text in the source data. In that case, when you do VLOOKUP based on that source, that number column, you will not get the desired output. In this video, I will tell you how to solve this type of problems if the source data is, some numbers are stored as text, how to respond to them. I have given two options, two solutions to this type of errors. By the way, I am Venkat Reddy. I welcome all of you to my channel, Venkat Reddy Excellent. Let's jump into the video quickly. Sometimes the table we are working with might contain numbers stored as text. In that scenario, we are VLOOKUP or retrieving the data, there is no problem. But if you are looking based on that column itself, then you will face some error values. In this example, here batch number and unit cost is there. In this scenario, I have converted two numbers to numbers stored as text. Here 60 and 90 are converted, stored as text. In this scenario, here I have some batch numbers. I want to get the unit cost here. I will show in two methods. First method is, we can change the source itself by converting them into numbers. The first method is, here we have the option convert to number. When you click on the cell, here is some context menu will be coming. You click that, you will get convert to number. You can do this by selecting control space and convert to number. In this method, we are changing the source formatting and rectifying them everything into numbers. And another method to change the source itself is using some paste special values. Paste special, either we have some multiple options, I will show one of them. I am just copy a zero value and entire thing a paste special values, and I am using some operation on that add. By this method also, we can change the data source to number format, or you may multiply one and paste special. So you have multiple options. In some cases, you may not have control over the source file. You may not have the control over source file, so you cannot do these two options. In that scenario, how to VLOOKUP, I will show you. Here, I am using two scenarios, two of solutions for this, without converting numbers. One is concatenating a double quotes and using if error. The second option is using an array formula. First, I will show using the double quotes and if error. I'm just typing if VLOOKUP, select the batch, selecting these two columns, fixing the range. Second column I require, and I am putting false, or I can put zero also. Both are same. Just pressing enter. Here this 40 is not available, so you won't get VLOOKUP here. I'm just searching 40 is available or not. It's not available. So let us see wherever the values are there. Here 81 is available here, and that is stored as a number only. That's why it's getting VLOOKUP here. And 50 also in the same way. 50 also number is stored as number only. And here 60 and 90, these two cells, even though the value is available here, that's not getting output here. In this scenario, I am using a special condition. Here, this I4 is concatenated by double quotes without any space, by two double quotes. Just pressing enter. Here in this scenario, numbers stored as text only coming as output. And what about the actual numbers? For this, I am using if error condition. If error, copy this formula again. Here in one place you don't need to put any concatenation. Now let us see whether the output is coming correctly or not. This 40 and 85 are really not available in this source data, and the numbers and the numbers stored as text, these four are available, and all four are I am getting VLOOKUP output. This is the first method. And in second scenario, I am using an array formula. Let's type it. VLOOKUP, select this number here. I am using a value formula here. The entire range I am converting into values. So here, this batch number I am converting entire range I am converting into values. Comma, second column I require 0. Here if I just press enter, I will get some value error. For any array formula, we have to press Ctrl Shift and enter combinedly. You can observe whether you put Ctrl Shift Enter or normal enter by observing these brackets, beginning and ending, prefix and suffix with a bracket. Now copy this formula down. I'm just copying it down. In this method also, you can get the output. Even some of the source data is converted to numbers stored as text. In this array formula, there is a drawback. For example, if all the range where contents are in values, then only this formula will work. Let us see if we type any text value here. Here, for example, I am pressing some text. In this scenario, the first formula is getting correct value, and the second formula we have applied is not getting correct value. You can choose any one of them based up depending upon your source data. Whether all are in numbers, you can use any one of them. And if there is any some text, really text data is there, in that case I prefer to use this if error and double quotes. Please practice these steps with your own data and give me your feedback in the comment section. If you like this video, please like, share, comment, and subscribe to my channel.